All right, this is old Instagram ads campaigns for dating. Day tree. All right, so these first four campaigns are basically the same. You can see I basically started them all at the same time. It's like the same photos, just with different messaging on them. I'm just trying to see what the heck would happen. And I think I got like, what was that, like 75 messages from them. So I was like, okay, I'm getting bad messages. That's good. And I had spent $200 on it to get 75 messages. And then I'm pretty sure I hired a dude from Upwork to like teach me the Facebook ads, like this back end, you know, this system here that I'm clicking through. And I don't know, bounce ideas off for how to strategize to get dates from IG ads with a DM objective. And he thought it was really cool, yeah, and he wanted to do it with me. His name was Aditya. And yeah, he had never even heard of using Instagram ads for getting dates before, so he thought it was interesting to him. So, like, so it's like, yeah, you know, I paused here January 24th, and, like, you know, that same week, went and got a dude on Upwork to, like, ask all my questions to, get help from. And so it's like we started the next campaign February 3rd. All right, so let's actually compare this Mackey's campaign. So it looks like it to the other ones. So basically, yeah, this is where my like 0.50% result rate came from that I remembered. So way less message cost, which could also mean I'm providing less context. So, you know, wider, you know, so it appeals to a wider range of people. So it's less context, which means they're less intent. You know, that's why customer message really doesn't matter at all. I mean, it's a good thing to look at when you're starting out learning this stuff, but it doesn't matter at all. Because if you get, you know, one message at $50 and it's 100%, you're going to meet up and bang first date. And she'll stay with you, you know, you'll meet up at least five more times after that, subsequent weeks. Then it's better than an 80 cent per DM cost. All right, so frequency is 1.48, okay. Okay, so it looks like I actually went to like near the same number of people that I had been going to before. Way higher CTRL, so that's good, capturing more attention. This is like, this is like really the only thing that matters. And result rate. And maybe cost per result, if you can actually nail it down accurately. CTR link also a lot higher than my other ones. CPC way cheaper, which could be that I'm less context, which means less targeted, which means less intent. So, aka broader, you know, broader reach, so more people are clicking through, which is actually worse. We don't want that. Because then our, you know, if we're getting messages from those broader reach, less intent, lower intent people, Instagram's going to see, oh, the broader reach, lesser intent people are getting him the cheapest DMs. We're going to keep giving it to the broader reach, lesser intent people. So that's why it's actually not good. If your CTR link is high, if your cost per click, cost per message is low, if it's broad, you know, if you have some low broad intent, low context message. All right, so that's fine. Now let's dive in. It's fun actually going to check back on these things. I don't even remember what this ad one was about. So seven ads. So it looks like I kind of did the, you know, my top pictures from, let's go like this. Looks like I did my top pictures from those first four campaigns, plus I tested the video. So it says Photoshop. All right. So let's actually see what the heck I did. So somebody's got a lot of messages. 41 cent per message. Okay, so all of them got messages, which makes sense because I pulled from, you know, the best photos from the first four campaigns. And all right, so let's even look at what these creatives are. Preview. All right, so this is why I did only Instagram stories. There's no preview to show for this ad. All right, let's go to the next one. No preview to show for this ad. Maybe I got a I gotta refresh the page. Sometimes this happens. And if not, maybe you can pause the video and see what the heck I'm saying. Or I can go edit. Maybe if I click edit, it'll show me the preview. Oops. Ah, dang. Alright. Alright, what if I just do one of them? Preview. Let's see. Okay, what's going on? Alright. Okay, yeah, I do think I remember what that is. I'm gonna click edit here and see if it allows me to show the text. No, there's no preview show for this app. PS14. Okay, I'm gonna pause this and I'm gonna go find this. Find this PS247 and then I'll come back. Alright, I found my Dropbox folder with Facebook Ads Campaign 5 right here. Yeah, I still got them. Looks like, alright, so we'll go from like the most successful ones to the least. I gotta find Vid1. I don't think Vid1's in here, but I'll show that to y'all at the end. Alright, so the second best one, PS4. So let's see what the heck I said. So I got 83% result rate, 41 cents per message. American Media Florecimo. Que busco yo? So what am I looking for? Friends with benefits that I see one time each week. And we only talk to coordinate a date and when we're together. So, yeah. What am I looking for? Friends with benefits that I see one time each week. And we only talk when we set up a date and when we're together. Yeah, I mean, you can see, I don't think I got any women from this campaign. It could be because, you know, the, scroll over here. I'm gonna go find it. It could be because, you know, I only reached 10,000 unique women. Maybe I needed to reach 22,000. With this campaign for it to work, and maybe it would have been my best performing one. You know, I ain't got no idea, because I didn't remember. Like, I found out, oh, it takes 38,000 unique reach, aka unique accounts in her accounts, for me to get one high interest woman. So this is actually interesting, because I actually provided good, like, really good amount of context here, for like what the ad is about, and so I guess you can see. Provide a really good context. Let's actually look at the CTR alls. Yeah, I mean, really good context. Captured a lot of attention. Got really, really cheap messages. I mean, this is all the makings of a really good ad. Good result rate. Really good cost per message. Yeah, to me, this actually seems like a really good ad. Maybe I just didn't have the, you know, so this would be the top of funnel. Maybe it didn't have the middle funnel dialed in at this point, which is probably correct, which would have been like from first message to first date. Maybe I screwed that up in the DMs. I don't remember. And then I probably didn't have the I definitely did not have the bottom of funnel dialed in at this point. Cause remember, it's like late January to late February. I banged 10 different women in Lima, Peru, 8 from dating apps, 2 from IG DMs. So it's like, it wasn't really till I got to March, or, you know, after that sprint, that I, you know, had a ton of data points, you know, could see some repetitions, repeating trends in the, middle of funnel. So from first message to first date, you know, to, bang on first date, and then bottom of funnel will be like after banging first date. So I think this is a good one. Now, my advertising account did get, like, blocked or restricted eventually. Way after. I think, like, 6 months after I even left Lima. Maybe this could be one reason why. I'm not sure, but, this is actually a good context. Like, really good context. You know? What am I looking for? This one will talk. Or not, maybe it's not super good. Maybe it'd be better with a 10-minute vlog plus this, so then the women can see more about me. So, but this is definitely better than average context. And you can see, definitely captured a wide range of attention. Really good messages, or a really good cost per message result rate. And I do think two women asked, like, okay, I'm asking, me and my friend want to know what's the allowance or something like that, like a sugar baby arrangement. And I didn't go for them. I was trying to do the pay with time versus pay with money, but this could be used to get sugar babies. And maybe it made it past the Facebook sensor scanners because it was in Spanish. Maybe that's why it lasted longer. But yeah, you can see like really good CTRLs, really good, I mean, insane cost per result, really good result rate. So I have to say this probably would have been better, or I'd say it's definitely better than average. But probably simply because I probably didn't have the middle of funnel and bottom of funnel dialed in at the time, so I couldn't. And also, I didn't, have enough patience because I did not know, the 38,000 unique reach number at the time. But I definitely got a good response, so maybe this is the good call to action to have at the end of the 10-minute vlog for IG Date Planning Funnel 3.0, which is what am I looking for? Friends and benefits that we see one time a week and we only talk the coordinated date and when we're together. Because I remember at the end of the, because it provides more context, which like pushes the higher interest ones towards the high interest end of the spectrum and the low high interest to medium high interest in the high interest spectrum pushes them to more towards the low end, and like they don't click through and they don't fill out the application. But yeah, this one is actually a good amount of content. I mean, it's telling the women exactly what they're going to get if they click through and message me. I just didn't get, and I just didn't get many results, or I'm pretty sure I got zero bangs from this, but again, it's only 78 messages. Maybe it was 80 messages that I needed, and I just didn't last long enough to figure that out. Probably would be better, with a longer video of me so women can see more of me to make their decision, but this actually seems like a really good one. All right, so what's that? PS4, PS2. Hold on, let's go to PS2. PS2. I mean, it's the same text for all these. Friends with benefits that I see one time a week. Yeah, the same thing. PS34, check that. 34. Yes, 34. Okay. Yeah, I do remember it was like some of these were chopped off over here, so I'm pretty sure it's this one. PS 34, yeah, that. PS 16. Okay, is that PS 14? Is that? Now we got PS 7, PS 14. Okay, maybe I didn't use the chopped off one for 30, or maybe I did. Maybe it's just long enough before it got chopped off. PS 14. You can see the result rate and the cost per result over on the right. Okay. I mean, to me, this seems like really good context. Just didn't get any results from it. Let's see. And then PS7, which probably because I didn't let it run enough. Honestly, looking back on it. And also maybe my account got jacked for some other reason not relating to this. Could be. Que busco yo. All right. So those are those you can see. Definitely some winners here. 41 cents per message. I mean, definitely winners. A 1% result right here. I'm gonna go find that video. Hold on. All right, so I found the video. I don't think I have the sound recording enabled for this recording. I didn't turn it on. And I'd have to restart everything to go turn it on. Oh, and also, if you want to know if like IGDMs are better for you for ads to get more dates with women, or like YouTube vlog plus IG vlog ads, go click the link in the description. You can either click the Day Printing Funnel 2.0 or the Day Printing Funnel 3.0 vid to see which one's best for you, and then you can book a call if you're ready to go on ahead. I only work with max of 2 people total for each month, so that's full. You'll get on the wait list. All right, so this video, I don't have the sound recording, but it was like the old TikTok sound from the year ago. There, it's like da na 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 na. Oh, Coi Leray, where it's like da na 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 da na 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 na, you know, something like that. One of those Coi Leray like TikTok sound songs. You know, and I'll probably go record this. Apps on my jeans, like a some the song sounds like that. You know, I'll put the video on for the next recording. But here's, I actually paid a dude $20 on Upwork to make this, so it's the same. You know, the same thing. You know, same caption. And there's no, you know, I never had any media coverage from me running these ads, no like articles or anything, nothing. Maybe if I ran it longer that would happen, but no, yeah, no media coverage for me doing all this stuff publicly. But here, we'll see what the Upwork dude gave me for $20. Right, so that's a restaurant called Central, which I didn't even know existed at the time. Like, I'd already planned to go live in Lima. And then, like, a few weeks later, I found out this restaurant, Central, was literally rated number 2 in the world for, like, I don't know, the last 5 years. Or, you know, is in the top 5 the last 5 years of the all the best restaurants for the whole world. And I went as, like, $380 for me or something. But I was like, well, I'm going to be in Lima. I might as well go. So this one probably did the best because it was showcasing wealth, I'm guessing. And also video, you know, more context, you know, a little bit more context. Got better result rate, better, really good cost per result. But look, I only reached 2,000 women with it. You know, maybe if I'd reached 8,000 women, I would have gotten 2. Don't want to be friends with benefits where we see each other once a week. CTRL was third highest. Best CTR link click-through rate. This photo again, this photo keeps killing it. This PS4. And this is only stories placements. So I probably updated my strat with the Upwork dude to only focus on one placement and try to master that one, you know, that one placement. Because I don't want to have too many variables where I was, you know, trying to figure out why things were working or not working, blah blah blah. All right, so I'm pretty sure you did not hear the sound, but maybe you did. All right, let's go back here. So this actually is actually pretty good. I mean, it's direct, you know, perfect context for what they would get if they messaged me. Friends have been, I mean, friends with benefits one time a week. You know, I didn't lock down anyone. You know, maybe I just had a bad middle funnel strategy, but like the context in here is really good. Definitely above average. And I was not even thinking about context at the time. Or, you know, I was probably thinking more of don't say too much because women disqualify. But now, since it's, what is it, we're at a 16 months later, I'm now more context, so the incorrect women disqualify. The women that are not looking for the same things as me disqualify, so we all save time. And also, this means the ads would only go to the women that are high interest in what I want. Whereas I definitely think a lot of women were here to get my attention because maybe they saw the status, American man, or they saw the status plus wealth going to eat at this insane-o expensive-o restaurant-o. Or they're like waste your times in the DMs. So this probably would have been better, even just running this straight to a type form, so the women have to put in some effort, fill out like 10 steps, application to even hear from me. That's also another reason why I didn't like the DMs, because it gives women an option to waste your time. And it just pulls your attention away. If you open up the Instagram DM app, you see you got X number of messages, in the top right. And it's like, I don't even want to hear about it. I don't want to hear from women if they're not filling out an application. It's kind of my thought process now, but this is really good context. Let's go back here, ad sets. Is there any other metrics? There was one. I'm actually going to put it in here. Average. All right. I'm actually going to put this in. Type form. I thought I put it in. Maybe I didn't. Customize columns. There's one average video view length that I'm actually going to start using a lot more because it's a measure of how long you kept the woman's attention. So I'm assuming more attention, the longer woman, longer average watch time each impression gets means the more of me and context around me is entering the woman's brain, which is a higher probability of filtering out the from this, high interest segment of the total market. I really only care about the high interest segment, but it's filtering out the high interest segment from the low high interest to medium high interest segment, really finding that divide where that is. So average video, yeah, here we go. Video average play time. So let's see, what is that, a 20? Oh no, that's a 30-second video. Where is this button? Let's see what it's called. So let's see, actually, landing page view schedule. All right, I'll put that there. Video average play times. Let's see, out of 30 seconds, video average play time, and also we can see it. Okay, 5 seconds on YouTube ads for in-stream ads, they can click away after 5 seconds. But when we break this down, here we'll go to the breakdown, and I'll be able to see. Hold on. Oh, there's video average play time. So let's break this down by platform or placement. Oh, actually, it was stories only, so never mind. So on average, 22,000, or no, was that 10,000 women each saw 5 seconds of me, which is the big thing I preach to you guys. If every woman in your city knew you exist, would you get more dates, more bangs? Obviously, yes. So 10,000 women in Lima for, 5 seconds, I mean, anything over probably 3 seconds, we can say they know, we know, is them knowing we exist. And actually, there is a column for that. Hold on. Breakdown. Or I created a custom column for it, maybe in one of my other ad accounts. Ads. 3 second video plays. All right, I'm gonna go make the, custom metric. Well, actually, I'll show you how to do it. I definitely have this in one of my other ad accounts. 3 second video plays. So let's do this. Do this. 3 second video plays. That's for 3 second video plays. So we're gonna do. That's three. 3 second video plays. Three. Second video plays divided by impressions. Hold on. 3 seconds. I'm actually gonna read 3 second video. Well, they don't have any impressions to 3 second video. Oh, here we go. Impressions to post engagement. Oh, that's interesting. Impressions to 3 second. Maybe that's exactly what I want. Oh, there it is. 3 second video plays divided by impressions. 3 second video play rate. That's what I call this. 3 second. Or what did I call it? 3 second video view rate. Yeah, percentage. Around with access. 3 second video. Okay. Yeah, that's exactly what I want. So let's create this. Cost for 3 second video. Thought I brought that in. 3 second video plays. Here we go. We'll go here. Cost for 3 second video play. And then we got a 3 second video view rate. All right. This is good. So now it's probably the best way to decide these video things. Oh, look at that. Yeah, this is actually way better. So it's not really like on average 10,000 women saw 5 seconds of me. Actually, this is much better. So 600 out of the 10,000 women, they were interested in me enough from the jump to have me enter their brain by watching more than 3 seconds of the video. Okay, so that's actually much better. 600 video plays. Yeah, so we can say, well, 10,000 women definitely know I exist. So I guess we can say reach is making the women know me we exist. And then 3 second video play is some higher than average interest. So yeah, that'd probably be fair. Because the women are literally only interested in like, well, let's actually see. 613 out of, oh, that might be actually right here. So 4%. That actually makes sense because women only swipe right 4.5% of the time on Tinder, on dating apps, which may be even less now. As like hypergamy, you know, increases every year. You know, the share of women chasing the top men increases every year as more and more men hop online and enter the global sexual marketplace. So this should be, you know, if we equate this to a swipe right, you know, watching 3 seconds of a video, then yeah, close to 4% makes sense. And it'd be higher if I'm, you know, if more, you know, more of my impressions go to the women that are highest interest in me, which is what we can see right now. So we did stories, the breakdowns, so now let's do conversion device, and we can see, okay, view rate doesn't break down, but yeah, okay, definitely smartphone, that matches with all my data. Women that are closer to zero, so have less money economically, aka are more feminine, have more interest in men. Which means it should come, we should have more higher interest from the Android crowd. For anything relating to the sexual marketplace. Yeah, you can't see difference in results though. Probably because they don't want you to shut off the iPhone option for targeting. Because Meta makes more money when you advertise on more platforms, placements, blah, blah, blah. Link clicks. All right, so actually the most interesting one here will be age. Age placement, country path. Okay. Oh, so I only did 18 to 24. Okay. Okay. So maybe I took my learnings from those first four campaigns in parallel. And so I was 18 to 34 women. I didn't have the data that 25 to 34 is highest interest to bang me, but I was just taking the initial best results, you know, try to save me some money with not advertising to the old bags. All right, so let's see here. Okay, 77 cents, cost way more results, which again is what's true. 85% of my bangs in Lima were from 25 to 34 year old women. Cost per result, impressions. Yeah, so I think my budget was at the ad set level, so it distributes. So it's like it distributed. Actually, we don't know the cost yet, but probably distributed 75% or 80%, 25 to 34, and then maybe 20%, 18 to 24. That's usually how it happens. Reach. And how long did I run this for? February 3rd. $30 a day. Okay. I don't know how many days I ran it for. Oh, we can check. Let's see how many days I ran this for. Okay, just 5 days. Or what? 3, 4, 5, 7, 12? I don't know. Maybe I accidentally turned it on these days for a little bit. I'm not sure. Okay, so I only ran this really 3 days. All right, let's go back to age. Results, result rate. I'd rather have less messages, like, you know, just an application now that I know. I'd rather not spend any time talking to women. Frequency is the same, clicks all, CTR all. I captured more attention with the 25 to 34 crowd, which is, you know, what my results kept being. CTR link, 1.16%. You know, way better here. Captured way more attention, or captured the attention more, and they went through it clicking more. And you see this chasm between CTR and CTR link is kind of like, it's like the more qualified women. Basically, it's the more qualified. So only like 1.16% felt they were qualified. So I said, you know, 75% got filtered out after initial attention from the ad to like watching it all the way through or seeing it or actually reading it to then just like 25%, you know, made it through. So that's that line between the high interest, or maybe these aren't even high interest, because if they're filling out an application, we could probably say high interest, but maybe this is a proxy for where the line is for high interest, then low high interest, medium high interest. Or what did I call it? Low high interest, or high low interest, high medium interest. You know what I'm saying. Somewhere in that high interest gradient. Cost per click. All right. Amount spent. Okay. So 2/3 went to this one. 1/3 went to the other one. Higher 3-second video view rate. 50% higher. And this was the demo, that demographic that was most interested in banging me. So it's 50% higher view rate, but they had like 7x higher bang rate. So maybe there's some, you know, super dramatic multiplier on this. We go from 1.5x more, you know, 3-second view rate. That ends up being 15 to 85. What's that? 5? 6. So 1.5x increase on view rate, or multiplier to view rate, you know, results in a 6x multiplier to bang rate. So there's some amplification there, which just means like further filtering further down the funnel. But you know, maybe we can start to build some approximations looking at this. And let's actually look for the ads from video to the, let's look at the video to the best photo. Campaigns filtered by selection. Yeah, let's look at age ranges for filter for and the different, you know, analytics for video versus the best photo. So I thought this was 18 to 24. I was, you know, reading it kind of upside down. All right, so yeah, 25 to 34, highest results rate. Okay, that matches with the age demo that had the highest demand to bang me. Same cost per result. Video got higher result rate. Okay. This photo actually got a really low cost per result, but that could also mean lower context, so lower intent woman. Frequency. So I got CTR all between video and photo. So the same text on each of them. More, so capture more attention with the 25 to 34 year old women with this. You know, maybe it'd be better to have this the first 5 seconds and then a video on, you know, with, you know, 30 seconds after. Maybe I'd combine them. Since this one captured more attention on the front end. Maybe, yeah, you know, maybe that would be the way to do it now. More CTR link clicking through with this one too. Huh. I don't know, maybe they're, maybe it's more broad, but, so there's less intent here, you know, I got no idea, because I didn't get enough bangs at the bottom of the funnel to really decipher. Higher CPMs for the video, I don't know. Well, for higher CPMs for the older age, because they have more money, so businesses are buying up those ad slots. So it's like, is that least effective at age 28 to 18 to 24 demographic? And like, I'll be more and more effective in the sexual marketplace to this demographic the older I get. So it's like, this is the cheapest that I'll, or this is the least effective I'll ever be in the 18 to 24 age range. Basically, I'll perform better with all age ranges as I, you know, increase my SMV, which means as men, as we get more money and grow older, our actually cost per acquisition or cost per bang goes down running these ads, which is, you know, that's why I wanted to run it when I'm young as possible. So if I get results when I'm young as possible, which I did, and like at, it's at the hardest point, I'm definitely guaranteed to get amazing, insane results when I'm older. Plus, the CPMs are cheaper because, again, if you you know, we're in the early stages of men using these strats. So yeah, if you want these super cheap CPMs between 18 to 24 year old women, you gotta start using these strats ASAP. All right, let's look at these. All right, yeah, there's no 3 second video play difference because this is a photo. 3 second video view rate, definitely. Okay. Yep, this makes sense. This demographic was had the highest demand for banging me. And again, none of them talked about relationships. None of them wanted a relationship, which is perfect. Well, it's because I set the frame perfectly from the jump. So they knew what to expect. 3 second video plays. All right. And is there anything, any other interesting thing to look at? Not really. I did want to see the difference between photo and video though. And view rate from the age ranges for the video. So yeah, this makes sense. So I'm glad I kept all the data so I could look back on it. All right. That's everything for today. Adios.